So now we will see two questions, then we will start discrete time Fourier transform. So question is, find Fourier transform of e raised to minus 3t u of t cos of 4 pi t. So here I can take this as x of t. So let x of t equal to e raised to power minus 3t u of t. Then its Fourier transform x of omega is 1 upon 3 plus j omega. So this is equation number. So I have considered this quantity as x of t. So I can use the modulation property. By modulation property, x of t cos alpha t Fourier transform is 1 by 2 x of omega minus alpha plus x of omega plus alpha. So here compare, so alpha is 4 pi. So x of t into cos 4 pi t will have Fourier transform 1 by 2 x of omega minus 4 pi plus x of omega plus 4 pi. So already x of omega is available in equation number 1. I can find out x of omega minus 4 pi. So x of omega minus 4 pi is, in place of omega substitute, omega minus 4 pi. So it becomes 1 upon 3 plus j omega minus 4 pi. In place of omega, now I will put omega plus 4 pi. So x of omega plus 4 pi equal to, in place of omega put omega plus 4 pi. So it becomes 1 upon 3 plus j times omega plus 4 pi. So I have x of omega minus 4 pi, x of omega plus 4 pi. Substitute in this equation, I will get the answer. Therefore x of t cos 4 pi t, that is nothing but e raised to minus 3 t u of t cos 4 pi t has Fourier transform 1 upon 3 plus j omega minus 4 pi plus 1 upon 3 plus j omega plus 4 pi. So this is the answer. Now next, determine impulse response of causal system if frequency response 5 j omega plus 12 upon j omega square plus 5 j omega plus 6. So what are the factors? So 5 j omega plus 12 divided by j omega plus 2 j omega plus 3, or you can say 2 plus j omega 3 plus j omega. So these are the factors. So I can use the partial fraction. So this can be written as a upon 2 plus j omega plus b upon 3 plus j omega. This is by partial fraction expansion. Just find out the value of a. So a is nothing but in the denominator of a 2 plus j omega. So 2 plus j omega times this term 5 j omega plus 12 divided by 2 plus j omega 3 plus j omega, and this we will calculate at 2 plus j omega equal to 0, that means j omega equal to minus. Here this term get cancelled out. So put j omega equal to minus 2. So a equal to 5 into minus 2, that means minus 10 plus 12, 3 minus 2, that means 1. So a answer is 2. Now we will find b. So b equal to 3 plus j omega times this term. So 5 j omega plus 2, 5 j omega plus 12 upon 2 plus j omega, 3 plus j omega, this we will calculate at j omega equal to minus 3. So j omega plus 3, j omega plus 3 cancel. 5 into minus 3, minus 15, plus 12, 2 minus, j omega is minus 3, so minus 1. So it becomes minus 3 by minus 1, that means 3. So a is 2, b is 3. So h of omega equal to 2 upon 2 plus j omega plus b upon, b is 3 upon 3 plus j omega. Now if I take its inverse Fourier transform, I will get the impulse response. So take inverse Fourier transform. Therefore impulse response h of t equal to 2 e raised to power minus 2 t u of t, because 1 upon a plus j omega is Fourier transform, e raised to minus a t u of t, plus 3 e raised to power minus 3t u of t. 3 is a constant, 1 upon 3 plus j omega is Fourier transform, e raised to minus 3t u of t. So while taking inverse, I have used this formula, e raised to minus 8t u of t, 1 upon a plus j omega. So this formula I have used while taking the inverse. So inverse of frequency response is impulse response. Next point is introduction to discrete time Fourier transform. So you already know the definition of continuous time Fourier transform. So what is definition of continuous time Fourier transform? X of omega equal to integration minus infinity to infinity x of t e raised to power minus j omega t dt. Now we have one discrete sequence x of n. So we will find the Fourier of discrete sequence x of n, and it is denoted by x of e raised to j omega, and it will be integration is replaced by summation n equal to minus infinity to infinity, t means n here, so x of n e raised to power minus j omega n. So this is definition of DTFT, discrete time Fourier transform. So we can find the some Fourier transform like delta n Fourier transform is 1. So delta t discrete time Fourier transform is 1. Delta t Fourier transform is 1. Delta n discrete time Fourier transform is 1. Then u of n, it is not absolutely integrable. So I know the Fourier of u of t. So with that, I can determine the discrete time, discrete Fourier transform of u of n as 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus j omega plus pi delta omega. So this term is similar in the u of t Fourier transform. And from where this term has come, that I will tell you. U of minus n minus 1 has DTFT minus 1 upon 1 minus e raised to minus j omega plus pi delta omega. So this is DTFT of u of minus n minus 1. Then we have studied the Z transform. In Z transform, Z is r e raised to j omega. When r equal to 1, Z equal to e raised to j omega. That means when we are calculating Z transform on unit circle, kahan pe? Unit circle pe. Then in that case, this Z transform becomes DTFT. So when Z transform calculated on unit circle, it becomes DTFT. So in the Z transform, I will put e raised to j omega. So I know that a raised to n u of n has Z transform Z upon Z minus A. Take Z common from denominator, so it is nothing but 1 upon 1 minus A Z inverse. So just put Z as e raised to j omega, you will get the DTFT. Therefore, a raised to n u of n has DTFT in place of Z e raised to j omega. 1 upon 1 minus a e raised to power minus j omega. So this is the answer. Can you tell me the DTFT of 1 by 3 raised to n u of n? So here a is 1 by 3. So it becomes 1 upon 1 minus 1 by 3 e raised to power minus j omega. So this is the answer, DTFT answer. So it is very easy. From Z transform, you can get the DTFT answer. Now, we know that a raised to n u of minus n minus 1 has Z transform minus Z upon Z minus A. From denominator, take Z common, ZZ cancels, so it becomes minus 1 upon 1 minus AZ inverse. So we know that Z equal to e raised to j omega, Z transform becomes DTFT. So a raised to n u of minus n minus 1 has DTFT, yahan pe z ki jagah pe e raised to j omega. So minus 1 upon 1 minus a ई रेस टू माइनस जे ओमेगा. तो दिस इज द आंसर. टी एफ टी हैज सिमिलर प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म. लेट शिफ्टिंग एक्स ऑफ एन माइनस एन नॉट और एक्स ऑफ एन माइनस सम अल्फा जेड रेस टू माइनस अल्फा एक्स एक्स ऑफ जेड. सिमिलरली एक्स ऑफ एन माइनस अल्फा विल हैव डी टी एफ टी e रेस टू पावर माइनस जे ओमेगा अल्फा एक्स ऑफ ओमेगा एक्स ऑफ ई रेस टू जे ओमेगा. तो प्रॉपर्टीज आर ऑल्सो सिमिलर लाइक स्केलिंग इन जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म सेम इन द डी टी एफ टी. कन्वोल्यूशन बिकम्स मल्टीप्लीकेशन सेम इन द डी टी एफ टी. सिमिलरली यू नो दैट जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म इज यूज टू सॉल्व डिफरेंस इक्वेशन. सो डी टी एफ टी कैन ऑल्सो बी यूज टू सॉल्व difference equation. Now I was telling you that u of n. So we know that u of n is z transform z upon z minus 1, that is 1 upon 1 minus z inverse. Take z common, z z cancel, so 1 upon 1 minus z inverse. So the first term in that DTFT, first term in the DTFT is 1 upon 1 minus what is z e raised to minus j omega. Z is e raised to j omega. Z raised to minus 1 is e raised to minus j omega. So the first term in the u of n DTFT is from the z transform. And second term pi delta omega. This term is coming as we have seen it in the continuous time Fourier transform pi delta omega. From that here also pi delta omega term is coming. Again, you should know that u of n is not absolutely integrable. So, I cannot use the definition. Instead, I have to use some other technique to get the Fourier transform. It can be continuous time or it can be discrete time.